A speech that I'm going to read word for word. I've been the best man before, speeches before, but never have I read from a piece of paper. And for me, it's really tough for me to be emotional, although you see some silly sides of me tonight, but I always kind of got to throw in a jab here and there so I don't shed a tear. But I'm not really a person who shows their emotions when it comes to like lovey-dovey stuff. I'm not really a big I love you guy. I'm not really a big hug guy. It's just not how I am, if you haven't realized that by now. I kind of rough around the edges. So this was definitely nervous for me to say, all right, I'm going to do this, I'm going to read this, I'm going to say this, because it's just a tough part, or something tough for me to do. I've never done it necessarily before. So usually my parents go without hearing I love you for probably, I don't know, months, years even, just because I just don't really say it. 32, it's been a while. I don't really say I love you too often, so that's obviously a fault of mine. But I think I give them appropriate doses of how much I love them sporadically. So this will be one of the things that hopefully they know that I love them. This award is going to be the person I would most like to be like award. I wrote it once, I didn't proofread it, so I may stumble. All right, that's just my excuse for getting caught up with tears, okay? There are a few people in life that you cross paths with, and there are nothing but great things that could be said about them. After interacting with them for a while, you grow fonder and fonder. You then start to admire their habits, traits, actions, etc. It becomes clear that there are characteristics about this individual you wish you possessed yourself. For example, who wouldn't want Casey's booty or Kev's amazing chest hair?
Hurry up.
He'll show it later. But seriously, there are things about these people that you wish you had yourself. The reason I chose this individual as the person I wish I was more like wasn't for his butt or his hair, because he has neither of both. Hold on, I lost my thought. But there is not a bad thing I can say about him, except for maybe his coffee breath or the fact that he needs to be literally up in your face when talking to you. Besides those two, everything else is good. Like how non-judgmental he is. He doesn't make anyone feel bad about who they are, the decisions they make, or the lives they live. He lives with great integrity. He does things for the right reasons and doesn't look to get over on anybody. He is humble. He doesn't think he is God's gift to earth, except for when he tries flirting with the other women in the box. He doesn't get fazed by criticism. He just lives his life without expectations of others. And that's something that I think that we all sometimes hold other people to certain expectations, but he doesn't. He just loves everyone for who they are. He is selfless. He is never too busy to give help to someone else. He doesn't choose what he would rather do instead of helping someone else out. There is never a favor too much to ask. He is happy. It's rare in life to find someone who always enjoys life as much as he does. He loves hanging out and talking to people, and I think this box has really changed his life. He loves making people laugh, even if it's at his own expense. He is loving. He has never made me feel like I wasn't loved. He never made me feel as if there was something more important. Any sacrifice would be made to make my life easier. I wish I was the man he was. He lives life with such innocence and positivity. He has always worked hard for everything he has attained. He has never quit despite plenty of misfortune throughout his life. A true individual anyone would admire and appreciate. I could never be him, but I wish I was my father. Kev still gets the picture though.
It was the night before Wadmas, and all through the box, John Condon was lifting while Kevin just watched. The barbells were nestled all snug in their stands, while Ben walked around, not on his feet, but on his hands. The coaches were huddled, the wad being addressed, while everyone stared at Casey's state of undress. Then in the box, there arose such a clatter, we all ran to the back room to see what was the matter. Ben arrived so first, so lively and quick, and we saw in a moment what made him so sick. When what did our wondering eyes did appear? No one had changed their shoes. That was quite clear. He lashed out and shouted and called the coaches by name. Come Kevin, Amanda, Tom, Coach Rich, and Coach Josh. We need to give the box a good wash. And then in a twinkling, we heard on the floor a scrubbing and washing like never before. Then after the mess was all dispatched, Kelsey Jamadar PR'd her snatch. Not to be outdone, Sky got right to work, and then she PR'd her clean gym. Coach Rich and Coach Tom worked with the CrossFit kids, and then Robbie started giving Jenna the biz. And then it came time for us to leave. Time to go home and take some leave. And as I departed and got to my car, I yelled, "Mary Wadmas to all, damn it, Jamadar."